Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Christ, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
Lord, have mercy.
May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to life everlasting.
Amen.
Let us pray. O God, who in the abasement of your Son have raised up a fallen world, fill your faithful with holy joy. For on those you have rescued from slavery to sin, you bestow eternal gladness. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, one God, forever and ever.
Amen. A reading from the book of the prophet Hosea. Thus says the Lord, they made kings in Israel, but not by my authority. They established princes, but without my approval. With their silver and gold they made idols for themselves, to their own destruction. Cast away your calf, O Samaria. My wrath is kindled against them. How long will they be unable to attain innocence in Israel? The work of an artisan, no god at all, destined for the flames, such as the calf of Samaria. When they sow the wind, they shall reap the whirlwind. The stalk of grain that forms no root can yield no flower. Even if it could, strangers would swallow it. When Ephraim made many altars to expiate sin, his altars became occasions of sin. Though I write for him my many ordinances, they are considered as a stranger's. Though they offer sacrifice, immolate flesh, and eat it, the Lord is not pleased with them. He shall still remember their guilt and punish their sins. They shall return to Egypt. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
Our God is in heaven. Whatever he wills, he does. Their idols are silver and gold, the handiwork of men.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
They have mouths, but speak not. They have eyes, but see not. They have ears, but hear not. They have noses, but smell not.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
They have hands, but feel not. They have feet, but walk not. Their makers shall be like them, everyone that trusts in them.
The house of Israel trusts in the Lord.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to Matthew.
Glory to you, O Lord.
A demoniac who could not speak was brought to Jesus, and when the demon was driven out, the mute man spoke. The crowds were amazed and said, "Nothing like this has ever been seen in Israel." But the Pharisees, "He drives out demons by the prince of demons." Jesus went all around to all the towns and villages, teaching in their synagogues, proclaiming the gospel of the kingdom and curing every disease and illness. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. Then he said to his disciples, "The harvest is abundant, but the laborers are few. So ask the master of the harvest to send out laborers for his harvest." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
My brothers and sisters, when we think of everything that's going on in our world, and we hear a reading like we hear this morning from the book of the prophet Hosea, we may have a temptation to become a wee bit depressed, or to look at the glass as truly half empty. And that's not what the Lord invites us to. First of all, let's remember Hosea. Hosea is an outsider to the people of Israel. But he comes into Israel and supports what they do. He and how they believe. He continues that even after his wife Gomer just didn't simply commit adultery, but committed adultery and got money for it. And it all became public knowledge. Yet Hosea remains faithful, even as he sees all the good that he is doing in the name of Yahweh being pushed aside. And then Jesus, he comes and he frees people from the possession of the devil. He cures those who are sick. He'll raise the dead. And the Pharisees are suspicious. They're sinister. And they spread the great malice of discontent and disbelief. But St. Matthew gives us this observation. At the sight of the crowds, his heart was moved with pity for them, because they were troubled and abandoned, like sheep without a shepherd. You see what allows Hosea to be faithful, even after he's been betrayed by his wife, even after the people do not listen to him. What allows people to come into the faith in the example of Jesus and not listen to the whisperings of the Pharisees is the fidelity of God. Think how many times in our own lives that God has been faithful, that God has pursued us, that God has relentlessly searched after us, that even when all seemed lost, dark, he brings us to the other side, and he brings light out of darkness, joy out of sorrow, good out of some sort of setback. Why? Because he is the good shepherd. May we be so blessed to be part of those laborers whom the Master finds. You see, the harvest isn't just about those who are going to guide and teach. The harvest is primarily about those who follow, who hear the word of God, and respond even when it seems pointless to the fidelity of God.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the bread of your offering, fruit of the earth and work of human hands. It will become for us the bread of life.
Blessed be God forever.
Blessed are you, Lord God of all creation, for through your goodness we have received the wine we offer, fruit of the vine, and work of human hands. It will become our spiritual drink.
Blessed be God forever. May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands for the praise and glory of his name, for our good and the good of all his holy church.
May the oblation dedicated to your name purify us, O Lord, and day by day bring our conduct closer to the life of heaven, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your heart.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks, Father most holy. Through your beloved Son, Jesus Christ, your word through whom you made all things, whom you sent as our Savior and Redeemer, incarnate by the Holy Spirit and born of the Virgin, fulfilling your will and gaining for you a holy people, he stretched out his hands as he endured his passion, so as to break the bonds of death and manifest the resurrection. And so, with the angels and all the saints, we declare your glory as with one voice we acclaim: Holy, 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 Lord God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon them like the dew, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and entered willingly into his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it and gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat it. For this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice. And once more giving thanks, he gave it to his disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it. For this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The the mystery of faith. When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again. Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life and the chalice of salvation, in giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and to minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity. Together with Francis, our Pope, Thomas, our Bishop, Robert, his assistant bishop, and all the clergy. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection, and all who have died in your mercy. Welcome them into the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the blessed apostles, and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be co-heirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify through your Son, Jesus Christ. Through him, and with him, and in him, O God, Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours forever and ever.
Amen.
At the Savior's command, and for my divine teaching, will we dare to say, Our Father, who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those who trespass against us. And lead us not into temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress, as we await the blessed hope, the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to your apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Lamb of God,
you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us. Lamb of God, you take away the sins.
Come to me, all who labor and are burdened, and I will refresh you, says the Lord. Let us pray. Grant, we pray, O Lord, that having been replenished by such great gifts, we may gain the prize of salvation and never cease to praise you. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you
and with your spirit.
May Almighty God bless you, the Father and the Son and the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Go forth, the Mass is ended.
Thanks be to God.
Our novena prayers will follow.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
O Mother of perpetual help, with the greatest confidence I come before your holy picture to implore your help. I confide not in my merits or good works, but in the fidelity of Jesus to his promises and in your maternal intercession. You, O Mother, have seen the wounds of the Redeemer and his blood shed upon the cross for our salvation. It was your dying Son who gave you to us as a mother, and was it not you who chose the sweet title of perpetual helper? O Mother of perpetual help, for the sake of the painful passion and death of your divine Son, For the sake of the indescribable suffering of your own heart, I plead with you to obtain from the Lord this favor which I earnestly seek, and of which I have such great need. You know, dear mother, how much Jesus wishes to bestow on all of us the benefits of his redemption. He has placed these treasures in your hands to be given to us. Obtain for me then, Mother, from the heart of Jesus, the favor which I humbly seek, and I will happily sing forever of your mercies for all eternity. Amen. O Virgin of Perpetual Help, Holy Mother of the Redeemer, help your people who yearn to rise again. Grant to all the joy of going forward in conscious and active solidarity with the poorest, announcing in a new and courageous way the gospel of your Son, who is the foundation and the summit of every human way of life, which aspires to a true, just, and lasting peace. Like the child Jesus, whom we admire in this venerated icon, we also want to grasp your right hand. You lack neither the power nor the goodness to help us in every need. The present moment is yours in which to act. Come therefore to help us, and be for all a refuge and hope. Amen. Through the intercession of Mary, Mother of Perpetual Help, may we be protected, accompanied, and blessed by Almighty God, Father, Son, and Holy Spirit.
Amen.
Hail, Holy Queen, Mother of Mercy, our life, our sweetness, and our hope. To thee do we cry, poor banished children of Eve. To thee do we send up our sighs, mourning and weeping in this valley of tears. Turn then, most gracious Advocate, thine eyes of mercy towards us, and after this our exile, show unto us the blessed fruit of thy womb, Jesus. O clement, O loving, O sweet Virgin Mary, pray for us, O Holy Mother of God,
that we may be made worthy of the promises of Christ.
Let us pray. Grant, we beseech thee, O Almighty God, that we who enjoy the protection of Blessed Mary, ever Virgin, may always enjoy health and peace in mind, body, and soul. Through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
Have a great day, everybody. God love you.